The struggle for women's suffrage in the United States is as old as our country. As the government was being formed, women, politely but strongly, asked to have a voice in the government. They were told, "Be patient, and we'll discuss this after we get things running."
Finally, in the 1840s, tired of waiting, women organized in support of suffrage and in opposition to slavery. When the Civil War exploded, so did women's hope for the vote. Almost 100 years have passed. Just how long will we have to wait?
I've seen hard times. I've lost my peace of mind. But I've never lost a fight. I've been betrayed in this bitter long crusade, but I always knew it was right. I keep hearing my mother's voice and the echo of other voices too, each one saying, "Carry on, we've placed our trust in you." If I could tell the truth, if I could pray, eyes closed, dreaming of a better day. If I could tell the truth, if I could speak my mind, I'd say,
we'll be right back.
abides in you.
The movement came to life again in the early years of the 20th century when women organized to march, protest, and demand the right to vote. This time, they were not so polite.
Women were beaten, jailed, and died for their cause. One may fall, but together we rise.
My name is Harriet Tubman, born a slave in 1822, died free. I've done what was given me to do, in my time, in my way, step by step, day by day, willing to work, willing to wait, willing to stand up for women, knowing that our time will come. Every great dream begins with a dreamer.
My name is Elizabeth Cady Stanton. Born in 1815, abolitionist suffragist, fought for liberty. I've worked and I've waited. I've done what was given me to do. Lit a fire, paved the way, step by step, day by day. Willing to work, willing to wait, willing to stand up for women, knowing that our time will. Don't try and tell me I'm only a woman.
My name is Susan B. Anthony, born in 1820. Suffragist, abolitionist, led the battle for women's rights. Black and white, always fighting to be free. I've worked and I've waited. I've done what was given me to do. Broke the law, crossed the line, and refuse to pay the fine. Willing to work, willing to wait, willing to stand up for women, knowing that our time will come. Men, their rights and nothing more. Women, their rights and nothing less.
Every great dream begins with a dreamer.
Nation, after 174 years, finally took notice. President Wilson and Congress reluctantly proposed the 19th Amendment.
Nationally, women organized the first League of Women Voters with the mission of educating women in good governance to encourage the informed and active participation of citizens in government.
Wisconsin women, proud to be the first state of the 36 needed to ratify, formed societies to aid local governments to educate thousands of prospective voters on how to register and complete a ballot while still maintaining their femininity.
Meanwhile, during hot summer days of 1920, the debate over ratifying the 19th Amendment raged on. By August, 35 states had ratified the amendment, and Tennessee was vying to be the 36th. 134 years of struggle rested on an all-male yea or nay vote. The emotions were high for both sides, and the arguments were often uncivil. The outcome looked doubtful. Why would men give up their power?
In rooms where we hide, in rooms where we lie to women. In rooms where we smoke, in rooms where we joke about women. In rooms where we trade, in rooms where we stray with women. We love the power, we love the power. We love the way we play the game. We love the power, we love the power. And we love to fan the flame. We love the headlines, we love the moonshine. We love to strut our stuff. We curry favors from phantom ravers. Enough is never just enough. When we take the reins of power, you know the future's looking bright. 'Cause when we take the reins of power, it's hot times, am I right? We love the power and the slippery bottom line. We love the power and we know we're doing fine.
In rooms where we meet, in rooms where we cheat with women.
We love the power.
In rooms where we fake, in rooms where we wake with women.
We love the power.
In rooms where we rule, in rooms where we fool with women.
We play to win and we will keep the reins of power. You know we're itching for a fight. And while we hold the reins of power, it's hot times, am I right? We love the power and the slippery bottom line. We love the power and we know we're doing fine. Doing fine. To see someone run, to see someone cower, is so much fun. When you're in power, this is America's finest hour. Victory must be won. So ladies, here we go.
In a strange turn of events, the fate of Passage rested on a note sent from a mother to her son. This appeal switched Harry Burns's vote from nay to yay. A son's love and respect for his mother changed the course of the United States. All it took was a woman's voice.
A woman's voice welcomed you into the world. A woman's voice sang you to sleep. A woman's voice guided your growing, gave you glowing memories to keep. A woman's voice has held your secrets. A woman's voice has shared her own. A woman's voice gave you a start, captured your heart when you were alone. Do you now seek to break these bonds? Do you seek to betray this trust? Do you now seek to still this voice which shaped your world? A woman's voice raised your children. A woman's voice taught them at home. A woman's voice guided their growing, always knowing children will roam. A woman bears sons to join armies, stripping the tree from the bough. And now she must ask yet again, ask of her men, who will fight for us now? Do you seek to be
Theoretically, when Tennessee scored the perfect 36, the 19th Amendment was a win for all women. In reality, it was not. Voting barriers were set up to exclude women of color and low-income women. Barriers such as state poll taxes, literacy tests, or correctly answering ridiculous questions like, how many bubbles are in a bar of soap?
A new type of racism developed, one of exclusion and separation. And so women who were not white and comfortable were not invited to join organizations such as the League of Women Voters.
While much of the recorded history of the women's suffrage movement honors the efforts of Susan B. Anthony and Alice Paul, it often makes little or no mention of black leaders such as Harriet Tubman, Ida B. Wells from Illinois, or Josephine St. Pierre Ruffin, a journalist from Milwaukee. Nonetheless, these and many other women of color continued the fight for suffrage and equality. Again, it took the protests, marches, and civil disobedience of dreamers.
Have to wait. How many weeks and months and years? How many lifetimes will it take?
How many lies, how many bribes, how many broken bones?
How long do we have to wait?
Even if we lose the battle here and now, in the end we'll win. Their hate is dying, this I vow. Soon we will take our place. I can see the change coming even now.
We are not born to hate each other. So keep this vision in your sight. We are the ones. Together we can build a better life.
Our job is not to curse the darkness, but to turn our faces to the light.
We are the dreamers, we are the dreamers who dare to dream a better life.
I may not live to see it, but you will. Do not doubt it for a minute. You will, and your children will.
I may not get to cast my vote, but you will. Do not doubt it for a minute. You will, and you
Rights Act of 1965 did erase some voting barriers, new ones emerged. On the 100th birthday of the 19th, women have not achieved financial, political, or social parity with men.
The League of Women Voters, on its 100th anniversary, realizes that their mission of making democracy work can only be accomplished when women and men of all colors and races are represented, and when all histories are honored.
Diversity, equity, and inclusion must be our foundation, not just a slogan.
Until justice is truly blind and opportunity is afforded to all, we will rise.
Every great dream begins with a dreamer.
Can you hear it even now?